I really feel like it's important that people retain an open mind and realize that there's really, you know, you can be taught these rules and you can learn about how someone does something, but you have to always keep in mind that however you want to do it, if it works for you, it's not wrong. So I've noticed that so many successful guys have very limited technical knowledge. They just have a certain desire, they want to hear something a certain way, and they just sort of fight in this $5 program called TouchOSC. And it's essentially allows you to build your own layouts and interfaces. So TouchOSC is really cool, but I have different pages, one's for, say, launching songs. And then what I've done is I've written my own VST program that runs inside Ableton Live, and it will query Live for stuff through the API that Live has, that they've developed for control surfaces. So it allows me to query all of the track names that I have, and then I get those in multiple banks of pages of tracks. So I can go through my tracks, which I've organized all by key, which makes it a little more fun to mix two tracks together. So I go through and do that. And then I can crossfade, I can actually do a lot of the mixing here, although I usually use the DJ mixer that the club has. And then I have another page that's a little more for processing manipulation, where I can do beat repeats and delays and engage my Lucifer plugin, which I still use in my sets. And then I have a page for Nerve, which is the software drum machine that I created that I sell on my label site, Expert Records. And so Nerve, I have a special version of Nerve, which I give out as well. There's a TouchOSC enabled version, and I have a template so you can actually control the whole drum machine from inside TouchOSC. And so I sort of have a modified page from that layout that I provide, just with the features that I need on there. And then, so that's more or less it, what I do with the iPad. And this is kind of fun because it allows me to be a little less tethered to the computer. And at, like at the Ultra Festival when I played, I went onto the crowd, crowd surf with this and still do stuff. Put it to a page where you let people do something, you're like, here, play some notes. So that's kind of my thing, and so it's more or less a standard DJ. I actually don't have another piece of gear I use called a Monome 256, which is like a 16x16 push button box that allows me to create the beats. So I don't really have the beat creation abilities with me right here, but I do have like whatever the default sound that I have running there, and so I'll mute for various parts of that in and out. So that's more or less it. I have some abilities that you can't do with Live normally, like nudge forward and back in a track. So if I want to jump ahead 8 bars, say before a track's audible yet, like I might be mixing out of a different one and know I need to cue ahead there. Or I can loop over any like 1, 2, 4, 8 bar section of a song, which is great for mixing out of one track into another, so it doesn't cut off and stop. So that's never good.
Dance party, if you guys weren't interested.